This is the follow-up to Board Game with Spin Wheel. It's Board Game with Spin Wheel Part 2. And now what we want to do is, when the spin wheel stops spinning, right now I can move both the players. We want to be able to have one player move at a time. And to do that, we go to the action layer frame 2. And we need to have some kind of a means of saying who and when. So right after this my global equals 1, I'm going to put a whole bunch of type. I'll go through it, then tell you how it works. Type. And if we look at it, it's an if statement. IF turns purple. Open bracket. Which player equals 1, close bracket. That's a test to see if this variable which player is equal to 1. And if you remember back on frame 1 of the action script, we have a variable called which player, which we made equal to minus 1 at this time. So I'm back on that action frame 2. So open bracket, which player equals 1, close bracket. That's a test. There's the open curly bracket for the results. There's the closed curly bracket for the results. And we're going to say player count equals 1, semicolon. This is a statement. We're making player count equal 1. And again, if I go back to frame 1, you can see we have a variable called player count, which is equal to 1 at the time. Now, if the which player is equal to 1, we're going to have player count equal 1. If, on the other hand, if, open bracket, which player equals minus 1, close bracket, that's going to allow player to be count 2. So open bracket, open curly bracket, there's the closed curly bracket, and says player count equals 2, semicolon. And there's the closed bracket for this if statement. And to make sure that each time we press the stop button, it changes, this variable which player equals which player itself times, that's the asterisk, which is the upper case of the number 8, asterisk, minus 1, semicolon. When you multiply something by minus 1, all you do is change its sign. So it's either going to be 1 or minus 1, 1 or minus 1. That's all that needs to be done here. And go to the last actions frame, and down here, if you look, we have both players here on our if statement here at minus 1. And all we need to do is take this which player here, the first one, and get rid of that minus sign, delete it. And now if we test it, hopefully we have no errors. It's very simple, I believe. No errors, that's good. I cannot move either player. I hit the start button. Tell it to stop. I want to move player 1 2 points. I can't move player 2, but player 1 I can move. Hit the start button. Hit the stop button. Now, I cannot move player 1, but I can move player 2. And that should happen every time we alternate players. This should be player 1, not 2, but this one. Okay, I hope that works for you.